In the 1790s, one enlightened country doctor, Edward Jenner, started to piece together the evidence in the fight against smallpox. His first clue, based on extensive personal observation, was that it wasn't just an old wives' tale. Milkmaids really were exceptionally pretty, mainly because they never caught disfiguring smallpox. Armed with these clues, Jenner went to the dairy. And what he discovered was that some of the milkmaids had been given a dose of disease, albeit one harmless to humans.
Cows suffered from their own disease that caused rather alarming-looking pustules. It's called cowpox. He observed that the pustules from the cow were being transferred onto the hands of the milkmaids. They were catching cowpox.
On the 14th of May 1796, he took 8-year-old James Phipps and introduced the pus from a cowpox sore on the hand of a milkmaid called Sarah Nelms into the arm of the young boy. 2 months later, he decided to see if the cowpox had given James any protection against smallpox. There was only one way to do this. James was invited back to have a potentially deadly dose of smallpox plunged into his arm. What James Phipps thought of all this is not reported, but fortunately the cowpox had worked. James had been the first person in Britain to have been successfully vaccinated. He had been part of what was perhaps the single greatest medical discovery of the century.